गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल। सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर, सो दैट इज थर्ड चैप्टर। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डन विथ सेकंड यूनिट, लेट अस गो विथ द थर्ड यूनिट नाउ। सो नाउ इन द थर्ड यूनिट विल स्टार्ट विथ ए कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जनरल रैंडम वेरिएबल। व्हाट इज दैट? A general random variable. What is this? What is a general random variable? It is also called as continuous random variable. It is also called as continuous random variable. So here we are calling x as a continuous random variable, or also called as general random variable. Now for continuous random variable we have a PDF. PDF means probability density function. What we have? We have a probability density function. Okay. Now, so before proceeding further, so let me briefly tell you. Here, in the second unit, we have discussed about x to be a discrete random variable. Okay, so what do you mean by discrete? It takes on finite set of values. Small x takes on finite or set of values or finite range of values. Okay, now so for this we have two important parameters. What are they? Probability mass function, which was denoted as px of x, and cumulative distribution function, which we have denoted as capital fx of x. Now this was the case for a discrete random variable. Now in this unit we are studying about continuous type of random variable. X is a continuous random variable. Continuous, or it is also called as general. Continuous random variable are also called as general random variable. Now what do you mean by continuous? X takes on infinity many values. Okay, now for this continuous random variable we are defining first parameter, that as probability density function. In the short form it is called as PDF, now which we denoted with fx of x. Please remember this is small f, small fx of x. This is a notation for probability density function of a continuous or general random variable. Okay, now so here what do you mean by continuous and discrete? So there is analogy. You might have studied in your course of signals and systems. There are two types of signals, x of t, which is called as a continuous signal, continuous time signal. X of n, it is called as a discrete time signal. Okay, in the same way here also we have two types of random variables, namely discrete random variable and continuous random variable. They have so much similarities, just like these two signals. Okay, so now we'll study a continuous type of random variables. For that we need a PDF which is denoted with fx of x. Now to find out the probability using PDF, what we do? Now what is this? This indicates probability that x lies between a and b. X lies between a and b, that is nothing but integration a to b fx of x dx. What do you mean by this? This is nothing but area under this graph. What is this? Probability density function. Now, so this is very very important. In case of continuous random variable, probability is nothing but area under the graph of the PDF. But what area? Area between A to B. we take the PDF graph. So if you want to find out the probability that X lies between A and B, we take area under that graph from A to B. Okay, I will take one example. So this is the mathematical notation of finding the probability from the continuous random variable capital X. Now, so here is the one more important thing, that is, so since it is a continuous random variable, including or excluding the endpoints of an interval has no effect on its probability. Okay, which means, suppose I want to find a probability that X lies between A and B. Here, this endpoints has no effect on the probability, which means here what happened? I have included both A and B. Here, I have included A but excluded B. Here, I have excluded A but included B. Here, I have excluded both the endpoints of an interval. Okay, so this is a closed interval. Now, this is open interval. And this is AB, and one more way you can write reverse. You know what you mean by this closed bracket and open bracket. Okay, so endpoints has got no effect on its probability if X is a discrete, if X is a continuous random variable. Please remember. Okay. Yes. Next. Now, so to qualify as a PDF, it has to satisfy certain properties. Okay, we'll see some of the properties of a PDF. What is a PDF means? Probability density function. Now, it should be non-negative for every value of X. Okay, what do you mean with it? What do you mean by it? So the probability must be, the PDF must be always non-negative. It could be zero, but it should not be negative, or it could be always positive. Okay, so here what we say is PDF must be always, the graph of PDF or PDF must be always greater than or equal to zero for all X. Okay. Now, this is another property, that is nothing but normalization equation or property. Now, so if you take, what do you mean by this? Try to understand things very, very carefully. Here, I am taking probability that X lies between minus infinity to plus infinity, which means this is area under the PDF, which is equal to 1. What do you mean by that? Okay, so this is very interesting analogy. Suppose if I say probability that minus infinity less than X less than infinity, it should be equal to what actually? Equal to 1. Why? Because X anyway should lie between minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, now this should be 1. This is nothing but total probability. Okay, so but according to the PDF, how to get probability? Area under PDF. Now area under PDF fx of x dx, but from where to where, which points? Minus infinity to plus infinity. This should be equal to 1. Now what do you mean by this? This is nothing but total probability. What do you mean by this? Total area. Okay, so since the total probability of any random variable should be equal to 1, that implies the entire area under the graph of any PDF must be also equal to 1. Total area, total probability, both should be equal to 1. Okay, this implies this thing. So the above equation implies the entire area under the graph of the PDF must always be equal to 1. entire area means entire probability. As I told you, so let me go back here. Okay, otherwise I'll explain with this. Okay, now here, so this is the PDF. Okay, now, so here, what is this area? This area is nothing but from A to B, which means this is nothing but probability that A less than or equal to X less than or equal to B. Now I am finding the probability from point A to point B. How to find out that? Take the area under the graph of that PDF from point A to point B. Now this area indicates this probability. If you take entire area of this graph, you take all area, the entire area of this graph, which means you are finding the total probability. You are finding total probability. That should be equal to 1, which means the entire area under the graph of PDF must be equal to 1. So that is nothing but total probability of any random variable x. Okay. Now, so this is the graph of PDF. Okay. So if you know the graph, you can find the probability by taking the area under the graph. But what area? That is given by the limits of the range. Okay. So if you take entire area, you get total probability of that random variable, which is always equal to 1. Now, so let us take an example. So find the constant C. So they have given a PDF. PDF is defined like this. It is C from 0 to 1, 0 otherwise. C is a constant. What is C? Okay. Just now I told you, to qualify as a PDF, it has to satisfy two conditions. I told you two conditions. What are they? It should be always non-negative. Okay. Let me go back. It should be always non-negative. And normalization property, which means so the entire area under the graph of PDF must be equal to 1. Now, so by using these two conditions, we can find out what is C value. Now, let me draw the graph of PDF. Okay, so what they're saying? It is C from 0 to 1. Is it okay? 0 to 1, it is C. 0 otherwise. Okay, this is a graph of PDF. So let me go back to the problem one more time. Yeah, it is C from when X is from 0 to 1, 0 otherwise. Then you have to find out what is C. So is it non-negative? Yes. C is some positive constant, so it is non-negative. But what about another thing? If it is to be qualified as a PDF, the entire area under the graph of PDF must be equal to 1. Now find out area of this graph. What is the area of this graph? Anyway, this is a rectangle. You can assume it's a rectangle. So length is 1, height is C. Otherwise, so 0 to 1 C dx, that is C. This should be equal to 1, which means C should be equal to 1. If C equal to 1, what will happen? So this is the square. Okay. Now what is the area of this square? So 1 cross 1, this is a 1. 0 to 1, 1. Area is 1. Satisfied. Okay. So to be qualified as a PDF, C value should be equal to 1. So we have done this problem by using those two conditions. Yeah. So we have to check whether this is a legitimate PDF or not. Or we have to find out whether it is a suitable PDF or not. Okay. Now, so what the first and foremost thing we should verify whether it is non-negative or not. Okay, it is always non-negative. And one more thing is, we have to find out the entire area. Okay, so 1 by 2 root x, right? So let us take this as, now what they given is, the PDF is given as 1 by 2 into root x when x lies between 0 to 1, 0 otherwise. Now, so we have to check whether this is a valid PDF or not. Okay, so what is the property of normalization? Minus infinity to plus infinity fx of x dx must be equal to 1. This is very, very important. This is one of the important properties of a PDF. Okay, so let us find out that area. So 1 by 2 root x, you find out integration 0 to 1. It is defined from 0 to 1, right? 1 by 2 into root x dx. So find out the this integral. What do you get? This is root x from 0 to 1. This is 1. So it is satisfying the property of normalization. This is called normalization. Okay, so it is satisfied, it is a valid PDF or legitimate PDF. So in the problem, so it is not equal to, actually it is only this, remove this 0 less than x less than or equal to 1. Why? Because if x is 0, it becomes undefined. No, yeah. Now we'll study one more problem, that is nothing but piecewise constant PDF. Okay, so we'll solve this problem, then we'll come to know what do you mean by piecewise constant PDF. Okay, next. So Arjun's driving time from home to work is between 15 to 20 minutes if the day is sunny, and between 20 and 25 minutes if the day is rainy. With all times being equally likely in each case, assume that a day is sunny with a probability 2 by 3 and rainy with a probability 1 by 3. What is the PDF of the driving time that is viewed as a random variable x? Okay, so Arjun is driving from home to work. The driving time is between 15 to 20 minutes if the day is sunny, and it is from 20 to 25 minutes if the day is rainy. All the times are equally likely. Assume that the day is sunny with a probability 2 by 3 and rainy with a probability 1 by 3. So we have to design the PDF of a driving time. Okay. Now, so here, right, first of all, let us find out the PDF. So of a driving time, x is a random variable, that is a driving time. Now, so let us take, it is c1. If x lies between 15 to 20 minutes, 15 less than equal to x less than equal to 20. C2, if, what is there in the problem? 15 to 20 and 20 to 25. It is from 20 less than x less than equal to 25. I can write 0 otherwise. Okay. Now, so but what is given in the problem? You go and check the problems. Clearly, you will find out one important aspect. What is that? So here I am assuming C1 and C2 are to be constants. Let me write here. Now this is the PDF here. But in the problem, it is given that, what is given? So assume that the day is sunny with a probability 2/3 and rainy with a probability 1/3. So if I ask you, what is the probability that sunny day, probability of sunny day, that is already known to us, that is 2/3. But how to get that probability from this PDF? How to get the probability of a sunny day from this PDF? What is that? What is that? It is 15 to 20 fx of x dx. Why? Because why? So it takes c1 on a sunny day, that is 15 to 20. Now if you calculate this, what do you get? 15 to 20, what is fx of x? That is c1 dx. Now from this calculate c1, but we know that, so this should be equal to how much? 2/3. Now calculate the things and tell me the answer. So c1 into 5 equal to 2/3, which means, sorry, c1 this is, which implies c1 equal to 2/15. In the same way, so what is the probability of rainy day? That is given in the problem. Probability of rainy day, that is 1/3. But how to get that probability from the PDF? How to get that from the PDF? It is area under the PDF from where to where? 20 to 25 minutes. So from 20 to 25, what is the PDF? C2. We are assuming it is C2. C2 dx. This should be equal to 1/3. So what will happen? 5c2 equal to 1/3. So c2 should be equal to what? C2 should be equal to 1/15. Now if you write the PDF completely here, fx of x equal to, it is 2/15 for 15 less than equal to x less than 20, and it is 1/15 if 20 less than equal to x less than 25, 0 otherwise. So this is the our required PDF, but please check whether it is a valid PDF or not. Okay, now so but I want to say that if you draw this PDF, it will look like this. How it look like? It is 2/15 from 15 to 20. So let us take 15 to 20, its value is how much? Let us take this much. That is what? 2/15. From 20 to 25, its value is half of this. So this is called piecewise constant PDF. It is called piecewise constant PDF. Why? Because as I told in the last class, it is a constant in pieces. Why? Because it is constant from 15 to 20 and it is also constant from 20 to 25. It is not constant altogether. It is constant in pieces. That's what is called piecewise constant PDF. Now, so in continuous type of random variables, we have first variety that is called uniform random variable. We have discussed this kind of random variable in the case of discrete also. There we called it as a discrete uniform random variable. So please go and check it once. Okay, 1 by b minus a, if x is between a and b, I have written everything there itself. Now we discuss same kind of random variable, but here we are talking about continuous type of random variable. Now its PDF will be defined like this, where c is a constant. So can you find out what could be the c value? Just now we have found out, we have done similar example. Okay, so let me go back and check. Suppose I am telling you fx of x equal to c if a less than equal to x less than equal to b, 0 otherwise. So for this to be a valid PDF, what must be the c value? You find out, think about it. Here I have written simply c. So for this to be a legitimate PDF, what should be the value of c? That is 1 by b minus a. Now this is the graph of the PDF, uniform PDF. Okay, a to b, 1 by b minus a. You take the entire area under this graph. What do you get? So AB 1 by B minus A, length into breadth, this should be equal to 1. So these are all the properties for a legitimate or valid PDF. Okay, now so this problem I just now told you, similar problem. What problem did we solve? We solved this problem, fx of x equal to c, 0 less than x less than 1, 0 otherwise. So this problem is being solved just now. In the same way, solve this problem and find out what is the value of c. You get, what you get? C should be equal to 1 by b minus a. If c equal to 1 by b minus a, now this will be a valid PDF. So the important property of a PDF is what? Normalization property, which means the overall area under the graph of PDF must be 1, or entire area of a PDF must be equal to 1. This is called property of normalization, which is very, very important. Okay, now this is the first type of random variable we are discussing for continuous type, that is uniform random variable. Okay, please remember the graph also. Now so next we'll discuss second type of random variable, that is exponential random variable. What do we define is exponential random variable. Now it is defined like this, and its PDF is like this, fx of x equal to lambda into e power minus lambda x when x is greater than or equal to 0 otherwise. So lambda is a very important parameter. I will tell you what is lambda later. Lambda is a positive parameter. Okay, now we will see what is this exponential random variable. Okay, please remember this PDF. So lambda into e power minus lambda x when x is greater than or equal to 0 otherwise. One more thing, you have to verify whether this is a valid PDF or not. If lambda is positive, lambda into e power minus lambda x will be always positive, otherwise non-negative at least. One more thing is, does this satisfy normalization property or not? You have to verify. So let us see whether this will satisfy the property of normalization or not. Now what is fx of x is defined as? The PDF of exponential random variable is defined as lambda into e power minus lambda x. When x is greater than or equal to 0, it is 0 otherwise. Correct? Now, what is our normalization property says? Integration 0 to infinity lambda into e power minus lambda x dx must be equal to 1. So let us find out what will happen. So since lambda is a positive parameter, you can take outside the integration lambda 0 to infinity e power minus lambda x dx. You have to verify whether it is equal to 1 or not. Now what do you get? Lambda into e power minus lambda x by minus lambda from 0 to infinity. So lambda cancel, you will get with minus e power minus lambda x from 0 to infinity. This is equal to 1. Correct? So it is a valid PDF. Yeah, you have to find out this. So what is this equal to? P of probability that x is greater than or equal to a. How to find out that? So probability that x is greater than or equal to a, which is nothing but a to infinity fx of x dx. But what is fx of dx? A to infinity lambda into e power minus lambda x dx. So then what happens? Minus e power minus lambda x from a to infinity. So you get e power minus lambda into a, or e power minus a lambda. Okay. Yeah. So these are the graphs of the PDF of exponential random variable for various values of lambda. If lambda is small, it is like this. If it is large, it is like this. Suppose how to indicate probability that x is greater than or equal to a, which means so x is greater than or equal to a. Let us take a is here. Now we are asked to find out this area. Okay. So this area indicates probability that x is greater than or equal to a. What this area indicates? Probability that x is less than a. This area indicates probability that x is, so this area indicates probability that this here indicates probability that x is less than a. Now this here indicates probability that x is greater than a. Okay. Now, so here, now we'll discuss cumulative distribution functions of what random variable? Of continuous random variable. Now, so here, let me write everything at one place, so to avoid confusion. So don't confuse. Suppose if x is a discrete random variable, which we have discussed in the second and first unit, it has got two parameters. What are they? Probability mass function, that is px of x, and cumulative density function. Sorry, cumulative distribution function, that is fx of x. Okay, now so if you take x is a continuous random variable, it has also got two parameters. What are they? Probability density function, denoted as what? Fx of x. Along with that, it also has got CDF. The notation is same. So I'll try to understand these things very clearly. Please try to understand these things very, very clearly. So CDF is common for both type of random variables, whether it is a discrete or continuous, it has got CDF with the same notations. Okay, so the only difference is, if it is discrete, it has got PMF, it has got PDF. What is common between these two? CDF, cumulative distribution function. And not only that, they got same notation also. Okay, so please don't be confused with these things. So please try to remember these things very, very clearly. So this page is very, very important. Okay, now we will discuss the CDF of a random variable x. Now this is a notation which is same as the CDF notation of a discrete random variable. Now the definition is also same. The only change is, here you get integration, there you got summation. So not only that, so if I tell you something like this, suppose in the signal system point of view, suppose if it is continuous signal, continuous time signal, we use integrations. Okay, if it is a discrete signal, we use what? Summations. So this is a scenario for continuous and discrete signals as well as for random variables. Okay, so you try to remember like this. Continuous means we do integration. Discrete means we go for what? We go for summation. Not only this, suppose, so here we take differentiation. Here what we do? We take difference. What is difference? Difference means, suppose x of n minus x of n minus 1. This is called difference, because we cannot differentiate discrete time signal. Okay, so to get a clear idea, suppose okay, so unit step and unit impulse. Okay, let us take these two are signals. Okay, unit step, unit impulse. Suppose let us take for continuous signal. Continuous. What is unit step? U of t. This is delta of t. How to get u of t from delta of t? Generally, we take integration. So, integration of unit impulse is unit step. Now, how to get unit impulse from unit step? Differentiation. Isn't it? So the differentiation of unit step is unit impulse. Integration of impulse is unit step. If it is discrete, what do you do? Here integration and differentiation. What do you do? How to get u of n from delta of n? Summation. Now how to get delta of m from u of n? What is delta of n? Here we don't say differentiation. What we call? We say u of n minus u of n minus 1. Now what is this called? This is called first backward difference. I hope you remember all these things. Okay, so if it is continuous, what do you do? What do you do? Integration, differentiation. If it is discrete, integration becomes summation, differentiation becomes difference. What it is called? First backward difference. It is called difference, not differentiation. Okay, so if you remember these things, now things will be very, very easy in the further classes. Is it okay? Now, so now how to find out this CDF? Obviously, area under the PDF from minus infinity to x, fx of t dt. I am writing x, fx of t, so this is another variable to avoid confusion. Okay. Yeah, so I told you so many times, this is accumulation of probability up to x. Yes, this is very, very important. Now, so please remember this. So this is PDF. What is this? CDF. How to get CDF from PDF? Integration. Reverse, obviously, differentiation. So this is PDF and this is CDF. Okay. Now, so if I write everything at one place, just like signals and systems, what will happen? Okay, let me write here. If x is a discrete random variable, okay, now what is the CDF formula from the PMF? What do you have written? I equal to minus infinity to k, sorry, I equal to minus infinity to x px of I. Okay, so this is getting CDF from PMF. Reverse. So what is px of k? That is fx of now this is the formula I have taken from the last class itself. Is it okay? Now what is this? I told you, what is this called? First backward difference. Okay, now suppose if it is reverse, if it is continuous, just now we are discussing, if x is continuous random variable, what do we write? How to get CDF? It is integration. Next, so getting a CDF from the PDF. Now how to get a PDF from CDF? You can write x or t, doesn't matter. Okay, write x. Now you got a difference. It is just like just now discussed unit impulse and unit step. This is a similar analogy, exactly same. Okay, in continuous case what happened? You just check once. Continuous case we have an integration and we have differentiation. In discrete case, what we have? We have summation, the summation, and we have a difference. Okay, so if you remember the concept of unit step, unit impulse for discrete signal and continuous signal, same can be applied to the discrete random variable and continuous random variable. Now here we are dealing with the relation between PMF, CDF, PDF, CDF. Okay, you don't get confused between these two. You go by logics, don't remember any formulas. Okay, now whatever just now told you are very, very, very important. Okay, so don't remember anything like that. You just go with the basics. Okay, anyway, so we stop here. Thank you.